Hello children, welcome to our science session. Let's continue revision of chapter 9, reproduction in animals. What is asexual reproduction in animals? The type of reproduction which involves only one parent is called as asexual reproduction in animals. That is reproduction in which there is no union of male and female gamete, and the reproduction which involves only single parent is called as asexual reproduction. And in animals, it takes place in the microscopic animals, or you can tell unicellular animals like amoeba, and small animals like hydra. Then in amoeba, explain asexual reproduction in amoeba. In amoeba, the type of asexual reproduction takes place is binary fission. Now we have to explain about the type of asexual reproduction, that is binary fission in amoeba. Here the amoeba, first it divides itself into two individuals, and the reproduction takes place in this way is called as binary fission. By means two, fission is dividing. So the parent, it divides itself into two. So it is called as binary fission. As we know that amoeba is a unicellular animal. That is, it is made up of only one cell. So as it reproduces, first the nucleus of the amoeba divides itself and form two nuclei. And that is two different nuclei. After the nucleus divide itself into two nuclei, then the division of the body of animal takes place, that is division of the cell takes place, and each part of the cell receive one nucleus. So in this way, amoeba produces, that is two amoebae are produced from a single parent. So you have to know about the diagram also, that is parent amoeba. It consists of single nucleus. First elongation of nucleus takes place, then which is followed by the development of groove on the cell membrane. Then division of nucleus and cytoplasm takes place, that nucleus divides into two nuclei, and each part of the cell receive one nucleus, and then it gets separated from the parent. So in this way, amoeba itself divide into two individual is called as binary fission. Then budding in hydra, that is like yeast, reproduction in hydra takes place through the process called budding. The hydra possesses different bulges. So you can see here bulges on the body itself, on itself, they are called as buds. Then these buds develop into new individual. Once the bud grows fully, see here the bud grows fully, then it gets detached, breaks off from the parent and become independent hydra. So each hydra like this, they can possess number of buds. So as a hydra reproduces by bud, this process of asexual reproduction is called as budding. So children, we have revised two types of asexual reproduction in animals, like binary fission in amoeba and budding in hydra. Now, what is cloning? That is, cloning is also the production, is a production of exact copy of a cell in or any other living part, or we can production of a complete organism. So what is cloning? Cloning is a production of an exact copy of a cell, any other living part, or a complete organism. Here cloning, it was successfully performed for the first time by scientist Lan Wilmet and his colleagues at Roslin Institute in Edinburgh, Scotland. They successfully copied a sheep named Dolly. So this is Dolly. What is the name of the cloned sheep? Dolly. And when it was born, Dolly was born on 5th July 1996 and was the first mammal to be cloned. Now explain the process of cloning Dolly. that is during the process of cloning Dolly, a cell was collected from a mammary gland of female Finn Dorset sheep. See, this one white faced sheep is called as Finn Dorset sheep. This female Finn Dorset sheep mammary gland was collected. Then the Scottish black elf, black faced Scottish elf sheep, from the sheep egg was obtained, and from the egg nucleus was removed. Got it? So they have taken two sheep, one is white faced Finn Dorset sheep and black faced Scottish elf, and from this Scottish black faced elf the egg, the nucleus of the egg was removed, and the nucleus of the mammary gland of the Finn Dorset sheep was inserted into the egg of Scottish black elf whose nucleus had been removed. Now the egg thus produced was implanted into the Scottish black elf. Now development of the egg followed normally, and finally Dolly was born. Though Dolly was given birth by black face Scottish elf, it was found, it is the Dolly was found to be exact, absolute identical to the Finn Dorset sheep, which has white faced, isn't it? White faced, because the nucleus was taken from the white faced Finn Dorset sheep, and it was inserted into the egg of, that is a egg which is in which nucleus was removed, isn't it? So here, since the nucleus from the egg of the Scottish black elf was removed, so Dolly did not show any character of the Scottish black elf. So in this way, cloning of Dolly was performed. Now, why does the child look like the parents? Isn't it? We resemble our parents, both the parents. Why does the child look like the parents? Because we know that fertilization is a process in which fusion of male and female gamete takes place. That is, male gamete called sperm and female gamete called ova or egg takes place. So the nucleus of the sperm and ova get fused together. So because of this, we know that a nucleus contains DNA which transfers genetic characters from one generation to other generation. That is why the new individual inherits some characteristics from mother as well as some from their father. And now next question, what is metamorphosis? Metamorphosis is a process in which young one undergo drastic changes as they develop into an adult, is called metamorphosis. That is, the young one of those animal, they do not resemble their parent. They different from their parent. So the process in which the young ones undergo drastic changes. For example, you can see tadpole of frog. Tadpole and young one of frog is tadpole, isn't it? It is entirely different from adult frog. So the process of development of change, that entirely changed young one into adult, is called as metamorphosis. Again, what is metamorphosis? The process in which young ones undergo drastic changes as they develop into an adult is called metamorphosis. And now next, define budding. We know that budding is a type of asexual reproduction in which new individuals develop from the buds. Name the main method by which amoeba reproduces. Amoeba reproduces by the asexual reproduction called as binary fission. Now next, we'll see some MCQ question. Internal fertilization and internal development takes place in dash. So hen, we know that it is internal fertilization, but it is external development. Frog also, external fertilization and external development, isn't it? So the same way, if you see, what is that? Internal fertilization and internal development. So elephant, it is viviparous. So internal fertilization and internal development takes place in elephants. Now, external fertilization and external development takes place in, just now we have discussed, frog, isn't it? Hen, that is internal fertilization, but external development. That is, chick hatch out from the egg, isn't it? So, development takes place outside the female body. So, external fertilization and external development takes place in frog. Now, when the embryo can be identified with body parts, it is known as dash. So, we have seen when the stage of embryo in which the body parts like eye, nose, ears, legs, hands, etc. can be identified clearly, that stage of the embryo is called as fetus. Yes, the option is, the correct answer is fetus. Now, metamorphosis can be observed in tadpole, earthworm, hen, hydra. So, we know that tadpole, the young one of the frog is tadpole, which is entirely, which undergo drastic changes during the development, during its development of young one to adult. So, metamorphosis can be observed in tadpole. The answer is tadpole. Now, ovaries are present in, so we know that ovary is a female reproductive part, isn't it? So, ovaries are present in females. Now, breaking of the eggshell and the chick coming out is known as hatching, incubation, fertilization, metamorphosis. So, we know that it hatch out, isn't it? Chick hatch out from the egg, that is breaking of eggshell, what we call that as hatching. So, breaking of the eggshell and the chick coming out is known as hatching. And choose the most appropriate answer. Yes, internal fertilization occurs in the female body, outside the female body, in the male body, outside the male body. So, internal fertilization, that if it occurs inside the female body, it is called as internal fertilization. So, in the in female body, answer is first option. A tadpole develops into an adult frog by the process of metamorphosis, isn't it? Metamorphosis. The number of nuclei present in a zygote is dash. That is, we get fusion of nucleus from male gamete as well as female gamete, isn't it? So it get fused, means it has single nucleus. So the number of nuclei present in zygote is 1. And now let's discuss some true or false statement. Oviparous animals give birth to young ones. No, oviparous animals means egg laying animals. It does not directly give birth to young ones, are called viviparous animals. So this statement is false. Each sperm is a single cell. Yes, true. See, a sperm is nothing but a male gamete. It is a single cell. The same way ovum or egg is a female gamete. It is also a single cell. So this statement is true. External fertilization takes place in frog. Yes, true. A new human individual develops from a cell called gamete. No, it is false. Isn't it? That is, fusion of gamete is called zygote. Then zygote develops into embryo. Then embryo into fetus. Then only it forms a new individual. It cannot develop from a cell called gamete. So, it is false. Egg laid after fertilization is made up of single cell. Yes, egg or ovum is a female gamete, which is a single cell. So, the answer is true. Amoeba reproduces by budding. No, amoeba reproduces by binary fission. So, the statement is false. Fertilization is necessary even in asexual reproduction. No, in asexual reproduction, there is no fusion of male and female gamete. Isn't it? The fusion of male and female gamete is called as fertilization. So, fertilization does not occur in asexual reproduction. So, this is false. Binary fission is a method of asexual reproduction. Yes, it is true. Binary fission, it is a asexual reproduction occur in amoeba. A zygote is formed as a result of fertilization. Yes, true. Then an embryo is made up of single cell. No, it is false, because zygote is a single cell which undergo repeated cell division. It forms a ball of cells. What it is called, what we call that as embryo. So embryo consists of many cells. So it is false. Okay, children, we'll stop here. That's all for this session. Thank you.